evening, guys. Yeah, earlier this afternoon, police holding a press conference to discuss what lies ahead for 18-year-old Marion Lewis. He was taken into custody on Thursday after being shot by Chicago police on the Eisenhower. We're told officers were surveilling him and tried to pull him over in the eastbound lanes of 290 around 4:30 that evening, but he crashed, tried to carjack another family, and then shot at police. An officer also shot Lewis multiple times in the arm, and he was taken to hospital. Now Lewis is facing 18 felony charges, including 3 counts of attempted murder and first-degree murder in the death of 7-year-old Jaslyn Adams. She was shot 6 times back on April 18th while going through the drive-thru at a Westside McDonald's with her dad, John Tay Adams, whom investigators believe was the intended target. He was shot too and is now out of the hospital. While Lewis will face a first-degree murder charge in that little girl's death, police made very clear today that they are looking for other suspects as well and stopped short of saying Lewis was the one who pulled the trigger.
Second suspect now charged with the murder and the death of a 7-year-old girl.
Police say 21-year-old Damon Gowdy was involved in the shooting of Jaslyn Adams while she was at a McDonald's drive-thru with her father 9 days ago. WGN's Patrick Elwood joining us now with the latest on this case from 26 in California. Patrick.
Mike and Ray, good evening to you. Another suspect in custody tonight. He is the second to be arrested and charged in just the last several days. But police are still looking for a third man thought to be the second shooter.
It was here at this McDonald's drive-thru in the 3200 block of West Roosevelt that 7-year-old Jaslyn Adams was shot fatally multiple times. That was back on April 18th. As her passing was mourned, police promised her killers would be found.
You can run, but you can't hide. We are going to bring you to justice for this crime.
Tonight, a Damon Gowdy. The 21-year-old was taken into custody only after a SWAT standoff at a home at 15th and Springfield. He led them in a chase that ended with him abandoning his car on the Eisenhower and then attempting to carjack another vehicle. Superintendent David Brown said Lewis was shot and wounded by police after he fired at officers first. Lewis was shot and wounded by police after he fired at officers first. By police after he fired at officers first.
I want to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Recha HaKodash, and double honors to the elder apostles and the elder bishops of Great Millstone. Also, sincere shalom to you other elders and you Akim, you brethren, okay, you followers of the truth. And let me say shalom to the elect, okay. I want to do another video off of a video I've done prior. This brother screen channel, this name here, has sent me a follow-up clip, okay, on a video I've done of this Jake that robbed the went up into a McDonald's and shot up Jake, a gangbanger, who was rolling with his 7-year-old daughter in the car. Okay, so we know that he purposely didn't roll her. He thought he has had a break, he could take his little daughter to McDonald's. But that lifestyle follows you, okay? But what I want to get into, as the brother put it here, Black Lives Matter, not. What I want to do is get into this Black Lives Matter thing again. And this is why we know it's all set up. You know, it's all backed by false Christianity, right? And they set the I'm not going to call them out their names, but do the research on these 3 so-called black women that they funded, right? For Black Lives Matter. Now, our complaint as brothers in the truth, okay, and followers of this truth, is since Black Lives Matter, why isn't this 7-year-old girl life matters? Okay? Because we know everything comes from the Lord, judgment from the Lord, but why doesn't this 7-year-old girl life matters? Now, there's guys who are supposed to be criminals, who supposed to be got killed, you know, for whatever reason. What's funny, let me say what's weird, is they got killed at the hands of so-called white police officers. But yeah, this guy, He kills a 7-year-old, attempts to kill the father. Then he goes and attempts to carjack, and then he shoots at cops. And they shoot him in the arm. You find something strange with that? They shoot him in the arm? So now he's okay? The person they probably should have took out is still walking the earth. That's crazy. It's all the Lord's show. That's what we say. The Lord killeth and the Lord maketh alive. You could do all that and the Most High spared his life for judgment or whatever reason, or whatever psyops or whatever the hell is going on. His life was spared. The carjacker, the child killer, the murderer, he lives. But a guy dies for a pack of cigarettes? Unreal. So I want to get in a couple of scriptures. I'll make this quick. Deuteronomy 28:28, it says, the Lord, we all know this, the Lord shall smite thee with madness and blindness and astonishment of heart. That word madness, and I'll get back into the commentary a little bit. That word madness, you know, these words can mean different things. Like Ecclesiastes 7:7, being mad means being wise. Okay, so you got to look up these words. Madness doesn't have anything on it. It just says madness. But when you go to the reference of it, 876:96, it says craziness, furiously madness. Right. So I went to the other definition of it.
Strong's H7696. Chagat. Chagat.
Okay. It just says mad, to be mad. It says primitive root, to rave through insanity. Right? Insane, crazed. In that scripture, that's what that means. Okay, I just wanted to touch on that. So anyway, we see that there were people marching to bring the killer to justice, right, who openly shot up this, it doesn't care, it doesn't matter if the father got killed, it wouldn't have been as big of a deal, but if the little girl gets killed, then it's a bigger deal, right? This also proves that black lives is not really mattering, because it's only mattering in particular people, right? This is what I see, black lives is not really mattering. It only matters when the white cops blows you away, you know, but we kill our own, it's all good. So you might say, well, there's people standing up against it, and they are fighting, and they're marching for the injustice of bringing this killer to justice who killed the little girl, right? But all those men that are being blown away in the streets, and this also shows you the bad parenting, okay, of parents and these sons, okay? So it's so much heat, so much stress put on you as a parent to keep the bills paid, the roof over your head, to work hard. And you see how important it is to have strong fathers in a home, because you got fathers that claim they're fathers and they're not really fathers. See, that's another joke. Try to put fathers in a home today, it probably get worse. Because, you know, everything's out of course. Okay? So let's go to Lamentations 4:1. So, the bottom line is, they should consistently have marches of the gun violence and the dangers in the streets. Every time a black man gets gunned down, there should be big open marches. But you know what they do? The media gets a hold of it, the medium, and they put a spell on it. It sells. It gets people to, you know, remember, this is all set up for entertainment. Entertainment means distraction. Okay? Which the Redstone family owns pretty much a lot of that entertainment. Anyway, Lamentations 4:1, 4:2. The precious sons of Zion compares to fine gold. Right? Let me go to 1. And this also precepts to, I believe, in Jeremiah, when it talks about how then could Israel is like a strange vine, a degenerate, you know, as a strange vine. How they become strange? They become degenerate. Okay, you know what? Let me get that real quick. I think it's 2, Jeremiah 2:11. Yet I had planted thee a noble vine, woolly a right seed. How then art thou turned into a degenerate, a regress plant of a strange vine unto me? Right? The Most High, this is the Most High show. He will make you or break you. He lifteth up and plucketh down. Okay, let's go back to Lamentations 4:1. How has the gold become dim? How has the most fine gold changed? This is the precept. Okay, I don't know if it shows that, but this, what I read, I kind of put it together. The stones of the sanctuary are poured out into the top of every street. The precious sons of Zion, comparable to fine gold, how are they esteemed as earthen pitchers, the work of the hands of the potter? Even the sea monsters draw out of the breast. They give suck to their young ones. The daughter of my people has become cruel, like the ostrich in the wilderness, out of control. The tongue of the sucking child cleaveth to the roof of his mouth for thirst. The young children ask for bread, and no man breaketh it unto them. Yeah, you got these black leaders, even some of these Israelites, that's looking to be fed the truth. Ezekiel 3:17 says, warn the wicked, feed the flock, feed the sheep, and they're going to tell you about the chip and everything that's going to happen. Then they're automatically just throwing that off, you know. It says that they did feed delicately are desolate in the streets, right? That they that were brought up in the scarlet embraces dunghills, right? How we fell so low, man, you know. For the punishment of the iniquity of the daughter of my people is greater than the punishment of Sodom, punishment of the sin of Sodom, that was overthrown in a moment and no hand stayed on her. This is bad, you know. But this is what the Lord set up, ultimately, so his elect can wake up, you know. So, you know, again, I just wanted to touch on that. Black lives matter. When does these lives matter? I think this woman named, young lady's named Jaslyn, little girl, or something like that. When do these lives matter, okay? You'll get a 20, 30 people with a Walmart card, particle board standing out there and write on it for justice. Hey, they caught the guys. You know, now these Jake's going to go back to sleep, right? Because justice has been served. But guess what? You got thousands and thousands of other Jake out there like that doing the same damn thing. And if you really wanted the justice, Jeremiah 8:11 said, they healed the dirt hurt of the daughter of my people slightly, saying peace, peace when there is no peace. If you really wanted so-called justice, right, which the scripture says, envy not the oppressors, we don't. But I'm saying is you Christians, you black Christians, and you really want justice, then you would have to go to the root of the problem, of the destruction of our people, of why our people like that. You would have to come to us and get answers and wait and receive the word, okay, and wait on justice. Wait on the Lord. Because if you all came back, which the Lord don't want you, then you wouldn't do any of this. You wouldn't have to be out there, man, marching and acting crazy. Meanwhile, the oppressor who set all this up, set you on a course and a path to live the way you do through his entertainment, through his gangster rap, and all his other madness. And when he acts out on this, he can come in and clean up the show and say, look what we did with these guys. So now we're doing a great service for you people. You people aren't awake, man, and that's what's wrong with you. That's all I have on that. Shalom.